All right. Pretty good. It is Monday, December 12th of 2011 here in the Calumet region. And, of course, this is going on about 26, 28 hours of no water in the city of East Chicago. And we have been addressing that all day long. The city of East Chicago, of course, is in a state of emergency due to the large water main break at Columbus Drive and Alder Street, and that occurred early yesterday. You heard it yesterday up and down WJOB as we kept you guys informed. We put it on the website, put it on our Twitters and Facebooks and all that. And if you're listening now, you already know that EC doesn't have any water going on and that it's a pretty dire situation. What we need to start thinking about right now is what we're going to do going forward. And it's kind of an ironic situation that actually planned today was for 8:30 for Mayor Copeland to come in here into the WJOB studios. This had nothing to do with the water. It's just his normal visit in here as part of the community programming initiative. But we spoke to him live on the air just about an hour and a half ago, and he gave us some updates, and he did say that he wanted to stay on the scene in East Chicago and that he would send somebody else into the WJOB studio. So making his first appearance ever with me is Ron Edmonds. He is a street commissioner with the city of East Chicago, and he's going to give you some updates and so forth. First of all, Ron, it doesn't look like you had much sleep last night.
No, we were up early, late at least. I guess I went home maybe about 1:30, 2 in the morning.
And, well, let's just start. How do you find out you have a water leak?
I was called, I'm going to say 5 in the morning yesterday, and was advised that there were some people that was out of water in the city, and that time I called the police department, and they told me that we had a large water main break at Columbus and Alder.
At Columbus and Alder, and if you guys don't know where that is, most of the folks here will know that. That's basically right by the police station in the harbor along Columbus Drive. As far as our best understanding now is that even though you guys are working over there feverishly right now as we speak, that road is still open, one lane in each direction, something like that, correct?
Yes.
And it's probably be better to stay away from that area if you can, though, right?
I would say so, yes. Either go down Guthrie Street or go around to East Chicago Avenue.
Yeah, you can go either one, either north or south. There's right. Plenty of other options, especially if you know the city of East Chicago and the harbor, Sunnyside, all that stuff. So let's, right now, we spoke to Mayor Copeland at right around 6:30 this morning, and he said hopefully around 9 o'clock they were going to have that capped off. Is that about right, I guess, still? Or?
Yes, we're hoping probably mid-morning, maybe 9, 10 o'clock, that we should have some pressure up.
Getting some pressure up. So, in other words, it's very close to being capped off, or it already is capped off at this point?
No, it's very close to
being capped off. Very, very close to being capped off.
Yes.
And so what kind of I mean it's aging infrastructure, just the cap blew off the end basically?
Yes, basically that's what happened. The infrastructure is like 75, 80 years old, and the cap just blew off, and the shutoff valve would not work. So that was the major problem.
All right, so that was 2 in the morning on Sunday. So it's been about 30 hours now that we've been good portions of the city of East Chicago are without water. Now, what is the, we're calling it a state of emergency. We're trying to keep as many people as possible that don't need to be in the city and so forth. You know, there's no schools.
There's no schools, yes.
No schools. St. Stan's is down. Advanced Federal Credit's down. The regional mental, what do they call it? RM mental health, RMHC, right? Our regional mental health center is down. You also have a couple of other folks that have called in and said they're not working today in the city of East Chicago because they don't have any water. But what about residents? Any emergency situations you guys have come across yet?
Well, basically that we're asking the residents for a boil order after we cut this water on. And we're also asking everybody to cut all the faucets off, completely off. Okay. When you do cut your faucet on, just cut it on lightly, a little bit at a time, because of some blowback that might be in there.
And we had a guy in and called. I asked him, "Oh, what about your faucets?" "Oh, they're on now. I'm waiting for the water to come on." It's the number one thing you don't want to do.
That's the number one thing that you don't want to do.
Yeah, it may tell you when the water's on, but you're going to suck all any backflow that's out there. It's going to come to you and not your neighbor, because your neighbor has the pressure built up.
Right.
It's going to go where is the least amount, you know, where the pressure pushes it. It would be your house.
Right.
Also, we had a plumber call in and mention that when you finally do turn them on at some point today, perhaps you turn it on in, say, a laundry basin or an unscreened. In other words, a lot of people's kitchen sinks have the screens up there in the faucet. Same thing on their bathroom sinks and on their shower sometimes. So you might want to go to an unscreened one in case there's any sediment that's going to be dropping through.
Yes, that is definitely correct. Basically, what's going to happen when they turn the water on, it's going to go through the system slowly, and it's got to go through the whole city and recircle and come back to where the break was at, and then we should be up to pretty good pressure and we should be good, but there's still going to be a 48-hour boil order. That is essential that people remember to boil their water for the next 48 hours.
And that is any kind of water.
Yes.
In other words, any kind of water. So people are going to ask this question. All right, they want to take a shower, and the boil order is still in effect. Can they take a shower with that water, or do they have to wait 48 hours?
I want to say that they ought to wait. I mean, I'm not positive on that question, but
okay.
I would say, I mean, what I was told this morning, that any water that you ought to boil it for the next 48 hours.
All right, what about St. Catharines? What's going on over there?
The East Chicago Fire Department is furnishing them with water for their furnace. We also deliver them some bottled water. Their situation is okay, I do believe, morning.
I just wonder, because there's a lot of patients in there, and you know, how are they going to the bathroom and flushing the toilets? I'm hoping that they have some sort of emergency water supply for that.
I'm almost positive that they do. Okay.
All right. Well, Ron Edmonds is here. He's street commissioner in the city of East Chicago. If you guys are just joining us, and I'll just read the release that was put out by by Steve Segura out of the multimedia division in the city of East Chicago. The city of East Chicago is in a state of emergency due to a large water main break on Columbus Drive and Alder Street that occurred early Sunday morning. This break has affected the entire city. Water department crews are working with contractors to fix the problem. If you know of elderly people who may need help or water, please help them if you can, or contact the health department at 219-391-8467. During this state of emergency, water will be distributed at the police department for residents on a first-come, first-served basis. Water is also being brought in the city through the help of local agencies and businesses. And I know that Mayor Copeland has thanked Mayor McDermott for sending over some of his folks from Streets and Sanitations also. Until we resolve the problem, we are asking that you conserve whatever water you have. Once the water is restored, we're asking residents to maintain the boil order on all water that is consumed for 48 hours after the problem has been fixed. So there it is. We will keep updated on that this morning, and I'm hoping that as soon as they actually cap that thing, they'll tell us.
Yes, sir.
And they'll let us know, and we'll be able to put it out there. Also, the school city of East Chicago has canceled all classes today. So is Ivy Tech, St. Stan's. You pretty much know if you don't have school by now. 219-845-1100. Ron Edmonds is in here. If you have a comment or a question on this state of emergency in East Chicago, do it right now at 845-1100. Hey, you're on the air. What's up?
Good morning. Yes, I'm here living in East Chicago, and I got a boiler here, too. I wonder, would the lack of water coming into the house affect the boiler in any type of way?
Turn your radio down. Now, it's not freezing out, so
no.
That factor is... I mean, if it was 10 degrees out right now, that might be a little different answer to the question. Ron, what do you think? I'm not a boiler guy. I don't
know. Okay, I would suggest that he would cut his water on someplace, let it run a few minutes, see how clear it is, and then
I can't get any water. No water is coming at all.
When they cut the water on, sir.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So what about in the meantime? It's been going, what, over 24 hours with no water?
Yes, sir. I mean, we have got to wait until they cap this water main that was bursted, sir.
Yeah, I know, but all I'm saying is that's going to affect my boiler in any type of way.
Hey, Bill, is that who this is? I'm sorry. Is this Bill?
Yes.
Bill, you know what? Neither Ron or I is a boiler guy per se, but we'll put it out there. We have a lot of industrial guys that listen, and specifically Kevin Gore of Gore Plumbing has called in a couple of times. And I'll see if I can't get one of our plumbers to call in and answer that question. I don't know, because I know they took water over because they were worried about the boilers at St. Catharines, right?
Yeah, that's what I heard. That's what I got me to thinking.
Yeah, so
I don't... Okay, but one more thing I got, too. Did anybody ever think that it maybe could have came from all these influx of trucks, all that weight coming down Columbus Drive? You think that could have had any type of effect on those pipes, jarring them or shaking them or anything like that?
That's a possibility, sir. I mean, I don't know. I can't say that for sure, but that is a good possibility.
Hey, Bill, excellent point. And
I think that should be looking at, and that bridge on Columbus Drive, that thing is starting to crumble, too, from all that excess weight. I don't know if anybody notices, but if you ride over that thing, the side barriers on there, they're all cracking up from where the bridge flexes. And you can see it's flexing quite a bit because it's cracking all of the concrete barriers on the side.
Yes, sir. That's a state issue because that's a state bridge, but I will
I think it should be looked at.
Yes, sir.
All right. Hey, Bill, good points, man. And he's right. I mean, there's a lot of extra weight that goes up and down Columbus Drive now since Klein Avenue closed. And typically, if it has to do with Klein Avenue, I've already thought about it. But Bill is one step ahead right there, and that's a tough question, man. I don't know what to do with that. We will look at that in the next few days. 219-845-1100. Hey, you're on the air with Ron Edmonds. He's street commissioner in East Chicago. Hey, what's up?
Yeah, this is Bob. I'm pipe fitter. Regarding your boiler question,
yep.
If you have a hot water boiler and it doesn't have a check valve, it can actually siphon back into your domestic water. So the requirements for the city probably didn't, on the older systems, didn't require a check valve. Like St. Catharines is going to have a check valve protection on there so they can operate their boilers because they have storage to make up water. But in a domestic hot water system for your heating boiler, I would suggest you turn the boiler off because you can actually crack the boiler if the boiler's all heated up and you're introducing cold water into it.
So turn it off?
Turn it off.
Wow, there's a lot of people in EC that have those old ones, don't you think?
Yes.
All right, man.
Because if you got a hot boiler and you're putting cold water in it, you're going to crack that boiler. Now, if it does have a check valve on your boiler, then you might be okay because the water is not going to be introduced back into the domestic water.
So you've got two issues there, cracking the boiler and then the second part of kicking some of that water back into the water you may drink.
Right. The requirements now is that you have a check valve on your boiler. 50 years ago, they didn't require that.
All right, man. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it. Once again, trying to sort through some of the issues. Obviously, East Chicago is a city with old infrastructure, and a lot of the older homes have still have boilers and that kind of thing. So we'll try to sort through it. I do know that one of the guys who called in and said he had all the faucets on in his house. I do know that's I know from doing this when my grandpa would come over and say, turn off all those faucets and let everybody else turn their water on for a while before you turn your water on. And you could do that, too. I mean, I'll just share what my old you know, German grandfather would do. When the water would go off, he'd keep us all shut off for hours after it got turned on because the sediment would be sucked up by all of the people who have turned their water on right away. But that's just one way. That's just one philosophy. Ron Edmonds is in here. He's a street commissioner with the city of East Chicago. If you've got any questions or you got any comments about what's going on in the state of emergency right now at 219-845-1100, let's go to line six. Hey, you're on the air. What's up?
Hey, good morning. Good morning. You know, I was wondering, I was thinking, you know, like the water systems run back to the 19th century and probably earlier, right?
Yes.
And so there's records of all this stuff. So, you know, that rather than hiring a private company to come in and monitor the EC water, you know, the piping, I mean, you've always had, you know, adequate people there that were really professionals at the water department. And the last election kind of, not this last one, the one before that, really disrupted everything, threw everything into, anyway, you know, repairing the old works is going to be a very costly thing. And so where does the money come from?
To repair what they're doing right now?
No. You see, this is just patchwork. And there's a lot of waterworks under our industrial areas that you can't get to. There's stuff that you can't really get to. There's stuff that runs along, you know, past the rivers and under the railroad tracks. I mean, there's a lot of antique, ancient waterworks under the city. And in order to really, if you're talking about they're losing like 30% through, you know, basically water loss. Through, you know, inadequate...
Well, basically what you're coming up is like, all right, this is a problem, this is aging infrastructure. What do we do? How do we pay for it going forward?
And massively, yeah.
You know what? We'll have to pick that up at another date, Victor. We're kind of dealing with the more immediate natures right
now.
Yes,
okay? I understand. But that's part of the... And then something else, you know, the loss of production that we were talking about the other day has to do with this. When you talk about a main breaking under a road that's been trampled on by extremely excessive traffic that's not really made for.
Exactly. Thanks a lot. And once again, that was a great question by a East Chicago resident. All these heavy trucks that would be going on Klein Avenue, they're now on Columbus Drive. If you guys haven't driven Columbus Drive in a while, at any time of the day, there are a significant semi-traffic and big, not so much coils, but a lot of construction outside contractors use that Columbus Drive.
Yes, it's, I stay right off of Columbus Drive, and the traffic there is great. I mean, it has increased a lot since the Klein Avenue incident.
And, of course, that keeps going on down, and some of it is actually a problem as kids are trying to go to school and so forth. And we talk about that. I mean, obviously, on a regular basis, I sit here and just gripe about, I can't believe that we haven't rebuilt Klein Avenue. So I think most listeners understand my position on that. But I had not thought about that. I mean, all these things just going over these pipes. Hopefully this is just an anomaly,
right?
A one-time occurrence. 219-845-1100. Hey, you're on the air. What's up?
Yeah, I got a question about the surrounding area, like Hammond and Hessville and all that. Does that Chicago water break affect any of that area?
No, sir. No, sir. We were, at one time, we was thinking about trying to get some water from Hammond. So,
okay, no. So then we're all, everybody's safe in Hammond.
Yes, sir.
It's a whole different system. East
yes.
Chicago has their own filtration
right.
plant. And where is that? Is that over by the marina, right?
Yes, they just built the new one, which is right off of Michigan Avenue. Okay.
Oh, that's opening
it's
now?
It's on Pennsylvania, yes, sir.
Okay, but it used to be right by the marina, and
yes.
they moved it over just to the west.
Right.
Yeah, you're okay. Where are you at? In Hessville?
Yeah, in Hessville.
Yeah, well.
I was just wondering. Okay, that sounds good.
All right, man. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
219-845-1100. What are you talking about? The filtration plant used to be right up between Klein Avenue and the marina there. And what's in that building now? Not much,
not
right?
Not much. Okay.
Yeah, really. All right. I had forgotten that they had moved that over there. 219-845-1100. And let's go to the phone lines. Hey, you're on with Ron Edmonds and myself. What's up?
Yeah, good morning, Jim and Ron.
Morning.
Ron?
Yes, sir.
On this, you know, like boil order, can you take a quick way around that and say maybe use water purification tablets or maybe even bleach in the water?
I'm going to say no, sir.
No, don't chance it?
No, no. Just bring your water to a boil for about 5 minutes, and then you should be good.
Hey, yeah, there's no way around that. And once again, if you keep all your faucets closed and then you open it up, say, in your laundry tub that doesn't have a screen on the faucet,
right,
and let it run for a while, then you will, there's really no other way around that, man.
Well, what do you suggest, maybe a few minutes to let the faucet run? One faucet run?
Well, we had the plumber call in earlier, and he was talking about letting the faucet run for quite a while, maybe your outside faucet also. Now, there's no freezing going on, so
right. You
can
right.
do that outside for a little while. All right, man. As we go along with the state of emergency here in East Chicago, we have to clear up a couple of things. One is that, you know, I didn't think that we had switched over to the new water at the new plant. And in the meantime here, the mayor had actually called in and said, hey, you know what, you guys are right, it's built. It's ready to go, right? And I think they've done testing over there.
Right. What was just told them is that we're waiting on some type of screens to be brought in, and then we'll be ready to go.
Okay, so it's very close to be able to put the new plant online. So kind of a lot of water things happening in East Chicago. If you're just joining us, the city of East Chicago, of course, is still in a state of emergency due to a large water main break on Columbus Drive and Alder Street that occurred early Sunday morning. Now, the issue is that it wasn't necessarily an in-use water main break. As far as I understand it, it was actually one that had been capped off, and it just blew the cap off.
Yes.
And there was nowhere to go but some tons of water coming out. And it's a 24-inch main, which is unheard of anymore. I mean, that's a big main.
Yes.
Think about 24 inches, how much water.
As wide as
as wide as it. I mean, and if you look outside to the water that's coming in here to WJOB, it's probably a one-inch main or something. So a one-inch main going into, like, businesses, and you got a 24-inch main going down the street. So you can imagine how that has worked. And, of course, it's over there by the water filtration plant also, so I'm sure there's a lot of pressure in there. But anyways, soon this morning is what we're hearing is that they're going to have that capped off, and they're going to start putting pressure back in the system. Just a couple of tips right now: keep your faucets closed for now, and once the pressure does come back into the system, you're going to have a 24-hour boil order, or I'm sorry, 48-hour boil order. Or if it needs to be extended or there's any other issues, of course, you can listen here to WJOB and get it, and or put it out in the Times, or also on Channel 2 or Channel 99 if you have UVerse. So let's go to the phone lines. If you guys have any questions about this, Ron Edmonds is here, 219-845-1100. Now, let's just go through the schedule again, Ron. It looks like we're going to have this capped off. I mean, you just talked to the mayor. He didn't say it was capped off.
No,
so
not yet.
As soon as it is, he's going to let us know.
Yes, somebody. It probably Herbie Cruz will give you a call just as soon as we know that they've capped it off and starting to cut the pressure back on.
Ron, of course, is a streets commissioner and head of streets. It's not commissioner. It's streets
director.
Director. I knew that was different. Okay. All right, so streets director. But the issue also is that if there are any elderly people out there that you're aware of still at this point, may want to check on them and may want to let the health department know at 391-8467 if there's any problems out there. Once again, the health department is 391-8467. So anything else you want to tell people right now, Ron?
No, basically I just want to make sure that they understand that we are in this emergency and that they do need to boil their water when it comes back on. We've got them. I cannot stress that enough to make sure that they cut the water on.
So in the meantime, I know that a lot of folks are leaving the city to go to the bathroom and have flooded some of the fast food restaurants and some of the establishments that are open. Evidently, there's a huge line over here at Walmart as we speak in Hammond. Of course, all you got to do is come over to the Nine Span Bridge, and then you're right over here at the Walmart and so forth. But hopefully that situation will be better, at least by early afternoon. May take a little while. I mean, Amir predicted around 9 o'clock this morning, which it is right now, but we're not quite capped off on that. So when it gets capped off, I'll let you guys know when there's some pressure coming back into the system. So we'll leave it at that. Right now, East Chicago is still in a state of emergency here at 9 a.m. and Monday, December 12th. And it looks like momentarily they're going to have that capped off and start putting some water into the system. Anything else, Ron?
Yeah, Jed, I would like to thank a couple of people that helped us out. Frank Miravan from the North Township Trustee, Structure Point, who also sent us water, the Red Cross, and basically all the city workers that came out and volunteered their time. I mean, there were the Health Department, Building, Multimedia, EMS, police and fire. I mean, we had a lot of people who come out and volunteer their time yesterday.
And, of course, Mayor Copeland pointing out that Mayor McDermott had sent some folks over yesterday also.
Yes.
All right. Well, we're going to get through this. It's not an easy time. There's a lot of, you know, a lot of people with young kids in EC, and there's a lot of old people that live in EC, and those are the ones you would most worry about. So check on your neighbors, my friends, and just make sure they're doing okay. And if you know somebody that lives in EC, you don't live in EC, can you call in and check on them and make sure they're doing okay, all right? And just stay tuned. I'll be on till 10 this morning. And then Gino will be on, and then he'll be keeping us updated. So we're done. Thanks a lot, Ron, for coming in.
Thank you.
City of East Chicago show is on here twice a month on WJOB. I thank you guys for watching, and I thank you for listening. AM 1230, WJOB.